I don't know about you guys, but the best way for me to always practice with the foreign language has been through film. Who doesn't love a good movie? And it's just even better when this movie becomes an opportunity for you as a learner to listen to the language being used naturally, to get some cultural insight, and to even get to hear to some interesting accents and dialects, which is something that you just couldn't do through a book, through a grammar book. I would like to hear the opinion of our expert teachers. Vasily, you've taught Greek as a foreign language throughout the world. You've taught in Argentina, the UK, and you are, of course, a valuable collaborator for the Greek Online School. Before we start our discussion on Little England, which is the movie we will talk about today, I would actually like to ask you something more as a learner than a teacher this time. Did movies help you improve Spanish when you lived in Argentina?
I still improve my Spanish by watching movies because it's a fun way to learn, actually. Who doesn't like a movie, a nice movie, as you said? And you can differentiate the level of the difficulty of the movie. You can try an easier, or you can start with an easier one. Our students, even the adult ones, the beginners start with Peppa the Pig. Did you know that? And I'm always surprised. Imagine a nice movie, how much it has to offer in this case.
Of course, we also have Maria with us, who is one of the most experienced Greek online school teachers and who also teaches in the biggest international school in Thessaloniki. Maria, did you like Little England? Would you recommend it to your students?
Yes, of course, I would totally recommend it. I have actually already recommended it to some of my students. I really find it a very good way to boost our students' knowledge and willing to learn. A video or a movie can give different stimulus, images, sound, backgrounds, landscape, body language, and as a result, they get to know a lot of things about the culture, which is directly related to the language they learn. And usually they ask for movies themselves. Even if we don't have something to recommend, they always ask for a movie or a video to watch. I think it was a really good movie, but maybe you could share your opinion on the movie since you have had a lot of experience with film studies and film criticism.
Right. Well, yeah, but our discussion today is not meant to be a review, but sure. What I could gladly say as a viewer, first of all, is that Little England feels like a great Greek epic. It is a story of lost love, of family, of fate, very Greek things. It is directed by one of the most important Greek directors, Pantelis Voulgaris. It is set in Andros, a Greek island of great nautical tradition, hence the title, Mikraglia, Little England. And it is basically the story of two sisters, a secret, and the way they try to deal with it. But at the same time, it is also the story of maritime Greece at the time of the interwar period. And what I would also like to say, what I absolutely loved about it, is the discreet but ever-present reference to Greek customs, traditions, habits, to ways of living, styles of living of that time and place. Would you, Vasily, say that all these cultural elements help a learner of Greek get in touch with the language, with the culture, improve?
First of all, it's inevitable to skip. How could you? It's there. It's part of the film, of the image and everything. Mm-hmm. And I would ask my students, my adult students, to make a list of things they were impressed by the movie so we can start a discussion in the class synchronously. about the Greek culture and the customs and the everyday life and how people do things generally. And this movie takes place in Andros, the pre-war Andros, which makes things more interesting, don't you think?
Yeah. Yes.
The dowry custom.
Yeah, then they would have to compare with, you know, nowadays. You know, many of our students have visited Greece already, or wanna visit Greece, and they would find interesting differences between the how things are going now, what was left the same, what changed, and that would be very interesting for them. For example, you can watch the marriage scene in the film, and you can see how the people are celebrating the marriage, how the people are dressed, how the people make a big deal out of it, like we do today. In a different way, we part in a different way, of course, but we still make a very big deal out of it.
I totally agree.
Vasily, how about Prika?
Yes. Prika, I mentioned the dowry thing, yeah.
And why do you think, because in this movie, for example, all these cultural elements that come to life, to my mind, really help a learner of Greek get an insight, which, from my experience as a learner of foreign languages, really helps with understanding the language and actually getting to speak it at some point. Why do you think that is? Why do all these cultural elements help learners speak better, improve their language?
This is the real language. This is the real life. This is how we speak. Even when we try to simulate in the class and to have experiences in speaking, it's impossible to have exactly this atmosphere as in a real interaction.
Yes, everyday vocabulary and slang, even slang, people students get to know the Greek slang through the movies, and it's a very good chance to actually learn some slang that they will hear once they come to Greece, and we use a lot with by the book, but it's a great opportunity to find the connections between the slang and the formal Greek, the connection words with the associated body language, because Greeks have an intense body language as well. So yes.
Yeah.
And talking about that slang and the kind of language that you speak in class and that they actually learn through the movie, how would you define the level of difficulty, Maria, of this movie? What is the level of Greek that is heard in Little England?
Well, the difficulty of the language, right? It's for an advanced learner to understand all of it, of course, or quite most of it, and even an advanced learner could actually skip the English subtitles or even use Greek subtitles to practice more. But for an intermediate student or a beginner student, it's quite challenging to follow. So I would really, really recommend that when it comes to such a big movie and quite hard to follow because it's in another time, another period of time, different situations, and everything is different.
Yeah.
Maybe it would help a lot that the students could read a synopsis of a summary of the plot before watching it, or
and talk about it. Actually,
yes,
you can
talk
have
about
a discussion.
Yes, exactly. Or learn about the characters a little bit, or even break to pieces.
Part.
You know,
well, it is a long movie. To be fair,
it is.
It's
yeah.
quite long.
Yes.
So that would also be understandable. But Vasily, you still think that a lower level student of Greek would still benefit from having watched the movie?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Even if you get few words from a movie, things that impressed you, this is a great profit for the student. But the teacher in the class must activate the students to make them speak about everything, about the weather. How was the weather in the movie?
Right. Yeah. The simplest things.
Yeah, the simplest things.
Yes.
Even. Did you like this beach, for example? Did you like Andros? Would you recommend to a friend? What did you recommend to your friend? Mm-hmm. Or about the silent moments of the heroes, the characters. What do you think she's thinking?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and even if they would have the opportunity to read some part of the script, some dialogues before mm-hmm. watching the movie, and it would be interesting if they were asked to, you know, imagine where they are right now, or where they live, how are they, how do you imagine the characters,
yeah.
even that, yeah.
Physically, like to give a yeah. physical description before actually watching it, right?
Yeah. Exactly. This is how we work with movies.
I think this is really interesting that you mention it, because I think that usually what comes to somebody's mind is that, oh, I have to be of this specific level of language to watch it. But you don't have to analyze the language, the movie in the language you're learning. Okay. You could just talk about it, about the
exactly.
simplest things, like you said, very casually.
Exactly. Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Exactly.
First of all, it's about a family. So... let's say that someone has to teach about the family vocabulary, the family relationship. So all he has to do is to take a part of the movie that brings all the family together. And there are a lot of scenes that do that.
Scene on a table during
yes,
dinner or something
exactly.
like that, for example. Yeah.
Η μικρά Αγγλία μας.
Μικρά Αγγλία. Παράξενο για βαπόρ.
Exactly. And name them. So who is who? Who is the father? Who is the uncle? Ποιος είναι ο Κώστας? Ποιος είναι ο Νίκος? No?
Ποιος είναι ποιος?
Ποιος είναι ποιος? Who is who? Yes.
But then if you get into the Greek relationships and you're like with words, κουνιάδος, γαμπρός,
yeah.
it could be very challenging for Greek people as well, sometimes all these family relationships.
They learning.
Let's give some advice to a Greek teacher who has a lower level student and they want to show them this movie, but they're afraid that they're gonna feel overwhelmed or trap the more advanced level of language and cultural things that you find there. So what advice would you, let's start with you, Maria, give to a Greek teacher to help their student avoid being overwhelmed with
mm-hmm.
this movie?
It's about fun. A movie is about fun. So
right.
let's give it to our student as a way to, first of all, have fun, to enjoy a good movie, and then at the same time, enrich their language and profit and benefit from it. So I would advise to break a movie into parts, into pieces, and give an easy part to the student who wants to focus on that in aspect of the language. Of course. I would advise as well to repeat.
Vasily, should a Greek teacher tell their student from movies almost 3 hours long? What do you think?
I don't think so. It's important. Since the movie is nice and it was awarded in many festivals,
mm-hmm.
this
yes.
specific movie.
It's a well-acclaimed movie, to be
well-acclaimed.
Fair. It's an excellent film.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the director is great. I would give my students the movie in advance
mm-hmm.
to enjoy at home, since the movie is subtitled, and choose maybe some parts of the movie to elaborate. We could role playing as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Make two students play a little part. Write
yeah.
the dialogue yeah. as it's heard on the
mm-hmm.
movie, the actual, yeah. You can do many, many, many things.
Right.
It's true.
It's endless.
Yeah. Yes, I think it's really, it's also really important that you mentioned the thing about the subtitles. And if a student is watching the movie through Hellenic Film Society USA, they can find it with English subtitles, which really helps.
Yeah.
Yes.
Totally.
So this is
quite
important. Yeah, I think it would really help to a lower level student. And how about some advice to a student of Greek, a learner of Greek, who is not attending classes, is not doing classes, maybe did in the past and is somehow still keeping the level the way it is or just trying to improve the language and is doing it through film. So could they still do it? Maria, how could they approach this movie by themselves?
I think that it can be totally done. I mean, they wouldn't learn the language how the way they would learn it in a traditional class. Mm-hmm. But if they have some background, some basic background, they could do it themselves as well. Yes, as I mentioned before, if they approach a movie with the purpose of learning or improving their language, they mm-hmm. should have more like a strategy, like to, for example, they can keep notes, first of all. Let's break the movie into three pieces and watch and then keep some notes and then try to figure out something about the characters or something about the plot. And then watch again. I mean, if you watch a movie with that kind of purpose, it's important to repeat. And in the end, maybe you will get to watch a part of the movie even without subtitles or with Greek subtitles, and then you have the result you want from a movie. Don't you think, Vasily? What do you think?
Absolutely, yes. I totally agree.
So I think all this was really useful. Thank you for this great advice.
Thank you.
I would, before closing, I think that we must mention that throughout this series of videos, we will try to give some recommendations and discuss Greek films and the way that we think, of course, that they could help learners improve their Greek. But I think that we should mention that the most important thing is that you find things that interest you and that you will binge watch in Greek and learn some words without even realizing it. I think that's what makes a great difference with movies, watching something that you really love, that you really like.
Absolutely.
So I think that would definitely make great difference to a learner.